God, who through the resurrection of thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, did vouchsafe to give joy to the whole world, grant, we beseech thee, that through his mother, the Virgin Mary, we may obtain the joys of everlasting life, through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. In nomine Patris et Filii, Spiritus Sancti, amen. In tua autorità, per te, e ben glorificare il tuo tutto, amen. Camera e sezione casa mia, degente non santa, ma non nel cuore lo solo, amen. Quei tu sei lo scudo di tu, ma il cuore tu dissi, poi tu sei sincero, tu non frigi, ma di cus. E mette luce in tu, per i patti, tu mi sei, tu sei un timonte, un santo tuo, che tu non la tua. E ti tu hai cura tali dei, di cui ti dica il tuo tutto, amen. Confidevo di vincitra, Deus, 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 quei si stari mamma, e al cuore tu, per me. Spero in Deo cuore, ma tu confidevo, in salutare con tu, me, e Deus, Deus. Gloria, Patria, Figlio, e Spirito, e Santo. Era il principio e nunca e sempre, e in segura segurorum, amen. E tu hai volatari dei, ed è incredificato in tutto meo. Autor nos mi nomine Domini, qui feci cielo e terra. Confidio del buon impotente, via gloria e sacrificio, via tre carità, in gloria di mio battista, santo sposo e spesso in paura, via tu mio marito, via tu mio santo, tu mio fratello, qui portami tu mi scoscienzione, per come d'opera, meo culpa, meo culpa, meo maxima culpa, ed è opera dove la tamaria in spirito, in potenza Deus, et missi peccatis vestis, per duca tua servita vetera.
Amen.
In urgenza mi solucionem et remissione, per torno solo in tribu ad nobis omnipotentem et misericord dominus.
Amen.
Deus conversus preferita abis nas,
et plens tua letabitur in te.
Ascendi nomis Domine misericordiam tuam,
et salutare tuam da nobis.
Domine exaudi rationem meam,
et clamor meum sancte venia.
Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spirito tuo.
Ordenus. Quasimodo geniti infantes, alleluia. Rationabile sine dolula concupiscite, alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Exultati Deo adjutori nostro, jubilati Deo Iacob. Gloria Patri e Filio et Spirito e Sancto, sic erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Quasimodo geniti infantes, alleluia. Rationabile sine dolula concupiscite, alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison. Gloria in excelsis Deo.
Et in terra pax omnibus bonae voluntatis, laudamus te, benedicimus te, adoramus te, glorificamus te.
Gratias agimus tibi proter magnam gloriam tuam. Domine Deus rex celestis, Deus patrem omnipotens, Domine figuri genite, Iesu Christe. Domine Deus omnibus Dei, filius patris, qui tollis peccatum mundi, miserere nobis. Qui tollis peccatum mundi, suscipet deprecationem nostra. Qui seris et dexteram patris, miserere nobis. Gloriam tu solus sanctus, tu solus dominus, tu solus altissimus, Iesu Christe. Cum sanctus spiritu et gloria Dei patris. Amen. Pax vobis,
et cum spirito tuo.
Ordem. sacrestus omnipotens Deus, ut qui Paschalia feste perigimus haec tele agiente moribus et vita tele amus. Per Dominum nostrum, Iesum Christum Filium Tuum, qui tecum vivit regnat ad unitatis Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Lex epistolae beati Ioannis Apostoli. Carissimi, omne quod natum est ex Deo vincit mundum, et hec est victoria quae vincit mundum fides nostra. Quies est qui vincit mundum, isi qui credit quoniam Iesus et Filius Dei, hic est qui venit per aquam et sanguinem, Iesus Christus, non in aquae solum, sed in aquae et sanguine. Et Spiritus est, qui testificatur quonium Christus est veritas, quoniam tre sunt, qui testimonium dant in cielo, Pater, Verbum, et Spiritus Sanctus, et hi tres unum sunt, et tre sunt, qui testimonium dant in terra, Spiritus, et aqua, et sanguis, et hi tres unum sunt. Si testimonium hominum ecipimus testimonium Dei meus est, quoniam testificatus est de filio suo, qui credit in filium Dei habet testimonium Dei in se.
Deo gratias.
Alleluia, alleluia. In die resurrectionis mei dici Dominus, precedat vos in Galileam, alleluia. Post dies octu iannis clausis detit Iesus in medio discipulorum suorum et dixit, ex vobis, Alleluia. In Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spiritu tuo,
sequentia sancti evangelii secundum Ioannem,
gloria tibi Domine.
Et illo tempore, cum sero esit eiro, una sabbatorum, et foris eis in clause, ubi erant discipuli congregatsi prote meum iudaeorum. Venit Iesus, et stetit in medio, et dixit eis, pax vobis. Et cum hoc dixisit, ostendit eis manus et latus. La visi, sunt ergo discipuli, viso Domine. Dixit ergo eis iterum, pax vobis. Sicut misi me pater, et ego mito vos. Ecum dixisit insufavit, et dixit eis, accipite spiritum sanctum, quorum remisereritis peccata, remituntur eis, et quorum retinueritis, retenta sunt. Thomas, autem unus ex duo dicem, qui digitur Didymus, non erit cum eis, quando venit Iesus. Dixerunt ergo alii discipuli, vidimus Dominum, ire autem dixit eis. Nisi videro in manibus eius fixuram clavorum, et vitam digitum meum in locum clavorum, et vitam manum meum in latus eius non creda. Et post dies octo iterum erant discipuli eius intus, et Thomas cum eis. Venit Iesus, ianuis clausis, et stetit in medio, et dixit, pax vobis. Deinde dicit Thome, inferre digitum tuum huc, et vide manus meas, et afar manum tuam, et vide in latus meum, et noli esse incredulus, sed fidelis. Respondi Thomas, et dixit ei, Dominus meus et Deus meus. Dixit ei Iesus, quia vidisti me, Thoma, creditisti, viaci qui non viderunt et crediderunt. Multa quidam et alia signa fecit Iesus in conspectu discipulorum suorum, quae non sunt scripta in libro hoc. Ec autem scripta sunt, ut credatis quia Iesus est Christus filius Dei, et ut credentes vitam habeatis in nomine eius.
Laus tibi Christi.
This Low Sunday, the epistle is taken from the first letter of St. John the Beloved. Beloved, whatever takes its origin from God must needs triumph over the world. Our faith, that is the triumphant principle which triumphs over the world. He alone triumphs over the world who believes that Jesus is the Son of God. He it is, Jesus Christ, whose coming has been made known to us by water and blood. Water and blood as well, not water only. And we have the Spirit's witness that Christ is the truth. Thus we have a threefold warrant in heaven. The Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost, three who are yet one. and we have a threefold warrant on earth, the Spirit, the water, and the blood, three witnesses that conspire in one. We are ready to trust human authority. Is not divine authority higher still? And we have that higher divine authority for this. God has borne witness to his own Son. The man who believes in the Son of God has this divine attestation in his heart. And the Holy Gospel is the continuation of that according to St. John. At this time, it was evening on the same day, the first day of the week, for fear of the Jews, the disciples had locked the doors of the room in which they had assembled. And Jesus came and stood there in their midst. Peace be upon you, he said. And with that he showed them his hands and his side. Thus the disciples saw the Lord and were glad. Once more Jesus said to them, Peace be upon you. I came upon an errand from my Father, and now I am sending you out in my turn. With that he breathed on them and said to them, Receive the Holy Spirit. When you forgive men's sins, they are forgiven. When you hold them bound, they are held bound. There was one of the 12, Thomas, who is also called Didymus, who was not with them when Jesus came. And when the other disciples told him, We have seen the Lord, he said to them, Until I have seen the mark of the nails in his hands, until I have put my finger into the mark of his nails, and put my hand into his side, you will never make me believe. So 8 days afterwards, once more the disciples were within, and Thomas was with them, and the doors were locked. Jesus came and stood there in their midst. Peace be upon you, he said. Then he said to Thomas, Let me have thy finger. See, here are my hands. Let me have thy hand. Put it into my side. Cease thy doubting and believe. Thomas answered, Thou art my Lord and my God. And Jesus said to him, Thou hast learned to believe, Thomas, because thou hast seen me. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have learned to believe. There are many other miracles Jesus did in the presence of his disciples, which are not written down in this book. So much has been written down that you may learn to believe Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and so believing, find life through his name. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Carissimi beloved in Christ, welcome to this broadcast mass on this Low Sunday, or Dominica in Albis, or Deponentis. Today, as we said in the week, the neophytes who were newly baptized on Holy Saturday during the vigil had in ancient times continued to wear their white baptismal robes, from which, of course, the alb that the priest wears is descended. And on this weekend, yesterday, they were taken to the cathedral church, which is St. John Lateran, of course, not St. Peter's, in Rome. And there they receive final instruction during that Mass, particularly, of course, with words from the Apostle Peter himself. And then today, after Mass, they would take off their baptismal robes. So today is often known as Dominica in Albis, meaning White Sunday, because of the albs. We have, of course, today too, this wonderful account, 8 days after the resurrection. So we are already told here in the Gospel narrative that on Easter Sunday itself, our Lord appeared to the disciples, to the apostles in the upper room, but Thomas was not with them. Thomas is rather incredulous about the fact that when the others say they have seen the Lord, he says, until I have literally put my hand into his wounds, I will not believe. 8 days following, on the Sunday afterwards, our Lord appears again to the 12 in the upper room, in the upper room, and Thomas is there too. Notice how straight away, after his greeting, Pax Vobis, peace be with you, our Lord immediately addresses Thomas. So if it isn't enough demonstration or proof, both of his resurrection, but also of his divinity, that having died, he has appeared in a room where the door is locked, straight away seems to know what Thomas said to the other disciples in the week, so that he addresses Thomas straight away. So often in life, we ourselves can be incredulous about various things. We can be, and actually it is prudent to be so sometimes. We must be prudent these days of computer hacking, of social media account hacking, of dubious emails offering us money from wills of people we have never known, just in return for our bank account details, and various other scams. Also too, sometimes the advertising world tries to sell us, always trying to sell us stuff, and sometimes something that is a bargain sounds too good to be true. Sometimes, of course, as well, in our interactions between each other, we sometimes demand or would expect some further proof. Was it completely unreasonable of Thomas to ask for proof? I don't think so. If anything, Thomas is demonstrating some prudence. I remember when I was confirmed, my father gave me a framed picture of calligraphy of Rudyard Kipling's famous poem, If. And it says there, if you can keep your head when all around you are losing theirs. And perhaps Thomas felt on that Easter Sunday that everyone around him was losing their head. After all, women, the Mary of Cleophas, Mary Magdalene and Salome had been to the tomb and run back and told everyone that it was empty. Peter and John had dashed to the tomb and had also found it empty. Then all these other disciples are also saying that in a closed room with locked doors, Jesus appeared to them. Perhaps Thomas thought, has everyone lost it? Can this really be so? And remember that St. John himself told us the other day in the Gospel that he and Peter had not yet, all the disciples, grasped everything that Jesus had told them before his crucifixion about his resurrection. It's almost as if they had forgotten about the transfiguration. And the point that our Lord made to them then, that it was in the hope that when the Son of Man is killed, you will remember this moment and retain your hope. Several times leading up to Palm Sunday, we hear our Lord saying to the apostles in the scriptures, the Son of Man must die, but he will rise again. One wonders sometimes, were the apostles really listening? Did they really understand? And again, our Lord suggests that the message was there in the scriptures too. Remember, on the road to Emmaus, walking with the two disciples, he explained to them everything about the Messiah and the resurrection through the scriptures. And it was with constant reference to the scriptures that he referred to himself as the Son of Man, that he referred to the prophecy of his dying, but also of his rising again. often when we are talking about the gospel or the good news with others who are not yet believers, one of the first things they often ask for is proof. How do you know God exists? Can you prove God's existence? How do you know the Gospels are true? How do you know that Jesus even lived, let alone died and rose again? And again, these are not unreasonable questions. How do we know that God exists? How do we know that Jesus lived, died, and rose again from the dead? How do we know that what is contained in the scriptures now for us, remember, for the scriptures for the apostles did not include the New Testament, but now we have the New Testament. How do we know that everything in there is true? Well, of course, there is 2,000 years now of tradition, 2,000 years now of belief, generations after generations before us have heard the gospel, responded to the gospel, believed the gospel, have trusted in the revelation of God in his word, both in the incarnation made flesh and in the faith, that single deposit of the faith once delivered to the saints by our Lord himself, to the apostles, and in their turn to successive generations. And indeed, we take much on trust. We take much on trust, both regarding the authenticity of the scriptures, regarding the traditions that have been handed down from generation to generation. And of course, we take on trust the authenticity of what they tell us, of what they tell us is true. St. Peter tells us that we ought to be ready always to give an account for that hope that we have in us. St. Paul tells us, extols to us, the three theological virtues of faith, hope, and charity. And it is in the exercise of these theological virtues that we find our assurance, that we find our basis, ongoing trust in the authenticity of what we have been told. By faith we believe. Our hope grounds our belief. Charity is our proof. What is charity? Sacrificial love. What is our proof then by charity? Of course, it is in the testimonies of the manifestation of God's love toward us, as accounted and recorded and testified by the apostles and by the saints. But it is more than that. Charity Charity is our proof because you and I and every Christian who's ever lived hopefully has felt and been touched by the love of God. Our trust in the authenticity of the faith is based upon a continuing relationship between ourselves and God and each other. Our faith, by the testimonies that we hear or have read or have shared. Our hope, grounded in what those testimonies testify. Not just the accounts of the resurrection from the apostles and disciples of the early church, but of the continual testimonies throughout the ages, of the witness of the martyrs, of the witness of the confessors, of the witness of the saints, who one to another, and generation after generation, have maintained and shared their hope that despite all the trials and tribulations of this world, it is all worth it for the sake of the kingdom that will come. And all that because they have known and have been touched and have shared the love of God. Those who have put their trust in God have themselves received the proof time and time again that He loves them. And every time we ourselves express sacrificial love one to another, we also manifest and testify to the love of God for us. Our belief is not based just on ancient testimonies. Our belief is based not just personal testimonies of the saints. Our belief is based upon the living faith, upon the living hope, and upon the living love of God and of the Church. We believe not just because we trust in these accounts of events 2,000 years ago, but we believe because generation after generation have borne witness in their own lives, in their own time, to the love of God. Know that God exists because we have been touched by Him. We have seen His hand at work in our lives or in the lives of others. Because of the inspiration and the motivation that we have felt because of the charity that we have felt or expressed between each other. Blessed are they who have not seen, yet learn to believe. All that time ago, my brothers and sisters, it's as if Jesus was thinking ahead to all those who would come to believe after the apostles. Indeed, is it not for that reason that he breathes upon them and gives them the Holy Spirit? Gives them the power to absolve sins. Here in this moment with Thomas and the apostles, Jesus is thinking of us. Is thinking of you and I. And is thinking of all those souls who have been, who are, and have yet to appear in this world. Who will arrive seconds, moments after this harmony, who will arrive tonight, tomorrow, the next day. Giving the Holy Spirit to the apostles and enabling the forgiveness of sins. So that every soul born into the world may know God's love for them. And of course, as he says at his ascension, "Lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the world." And truthfully, in that gift of the Holy Spirit to the church, we are touched, healed, restored, and forgiven. By virtue of that gift of the Holy Ghost. But also, too, we are blessed to behold him and his presence in the Holy Eucharist of the altar, where we receive that new manna from heaven, that bread of life, the means by which assures us of our salvation, assures us of eternal life, assures us of being with him in the new heaven and the new earth, when we ourselves will receive our resurrected bodies, when the fullness of the restoration and reconciliation of creation with God will come to fruition. But also too, we can see and we can behold the risen Christ. In the lives and interactions of the saints around us. We each and every one of us witness to the risen Christ, who expresses sacrificial love, voluntary love, selfless love. And in so doing, we testify to the existence of God. For as St. John says, God is love. They that live in love live in God, and God lives in God. lives in them. This is our proof. This is our testimony. This is our witness. That we who strive to live in love and in union with God and with each other make manifest the love of God to the world. Let us strive then, my brothers and sisters, to live out our faith and our hope and our love, that in so doing we may bear testimony to the love of God made manifest in Christ, by making him manifest to each other. For again, as the Lord said, a new commandment I give to you, that you love one another. For by this will the world know that you are my disciples, if you have love one for another. Let us, my brothers and sisters, strive to live in love and in union with God and with each other. And in so doing, prove the existence of God, prove the life, passion, death, and resurrection of his Son, empowered by the gift of the Holy Ghost, that we may bring ourselves and others to the fullness of our redemption in him, who is God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
Credo in unum Deum, Patrem omnipotentem, factorum caeli et terrae,
visibilium omnium et invisibilium, et in unum Dominum Iesum Christum filium Dei unigenitum, et ex Patri nantum ante omnia saecula, Deum de Deo lumine lumine, Deum verum de Deo vero, genitum non factum consustantiale Patri, vacuum omnia factus sub, qui propter nos homines et propter nostrum salutem descendit ex caelis, dicandatus est Spiritus Sancto ex Maria Virgine, et homo factus est. Crucifixus etiam pro nobis sub Pontius Pilatus paupus et sepultus est, et resurrexit sit dies secundum scripturas, et descendit in caelum sedere dextra Patris, et iterum venturus est cum gloria judicari vivos et mortuos, cuius regni non erit finis. Et in Spiritum Sanctum Dominum et vivificantem, qui ex Patri procedit, qui cum Patri et Filio simulatoritur et cum glorificatur, qui locutus est per prophetas, et unam sanctam catholicam et apostolicam ecclesiam, confitio unum baptismo et remissionem peccatorum, et expecto resurrectionem mortuorum, et vitam venturi saeculi. Amen. Dominus vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo. Oremus. Angelus Domini descendit de cielo et dixit mulieribus, quem caritis, surrexit sicut dixit. Alleluia.
Thank you.
Susum corda, habemus et Dominum, gratias agamus Domino Deum nostro.
Dignum et justum est.
Bene, dignum et justum est equam et salutari te quidem Domine omni tempore, sed in hoc potissimum gloriosius predicare, cum pastor nostrum emulatus est Christus. Ipse enim velus est agnus qui abstulit peccato mundi, in morte nostra moriendo destruxi, en vitam resurgendo reperandi. Et ideo cum angelis et arcangelis cum tronis et dominationibus, cumque omnium lisse celestis exegitus, in un gloriae tuae carimus, sine fire dicente.
Sanctus,
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 Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plenis sum caeli et terra gloria tua, hosanna in excelsis.
Benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini, hosanna in excelsis. robić głowy i będę dolił. Secula seculorum.
Amen.
Orne, proecepti salutalibus monetii de vene seduziali formati, albemus dice. Ad nos et quies in celi sanctificetur nomen tuum, et veniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in caelum et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum de nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentatione.
Sed libera nos a male.
Per omnia secula seculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum.
Et cum spirito tuo.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccatum mundi, miserabilis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccatum mundi, miserabilis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccatum mundi, Domine nobis pace. Domine non sunt dignus. Domine non sunt dignus. Ecce agnus Dei, ecce qui tollit peccatum mundi. Domine non sunt dignus, ut in te subtectum meum, sed tantum de verbo, et sed nabitur anima mea. Domine non sunt dignus, ut in te subtectum meum, sed tantum de verbo, et sed nabitur anima mea. Domine non sunt dignus, ut in te subtectum meum, sed tantum de verbo, et se nabitur anima mea. Brothers and sisters watching Mass online and unable therefore to receive the Blessed Sacrament,
We invite you now to make an act of spiritual communion, the words for which you will find below your viewing screen. My Jesus, I believe that thou art present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love thee above all things, and I desire thee in my soul. Since I cannot now receive thee sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though thou wert already there, I embrace thee, and unite myself wholly to thee. Permit not that I should ever be separated from thee. Amen.
Manum tuam, e conosce loco tavorum, alleluia, et noli esse incredulus, sem fidelis, alleluia, alleluia.
Dominus vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo, oremus. Caesimus Domine Deus nostre, lux sacro sancta misteria, quae pro reparationis nostre munimine contulisti, et praeses nobis remedium esse facias et futurum. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum Filium tuum, qui tecum vive et regna ad unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spiritu tuo, ite missa est, alleluia, alleluia. Deo gratias, alleluia, alleluia.
Domini benedictum ex abruncatusque in secula, autori nostri domini domini qui feci in cielo e terra. Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen. Dominus vobiscum
et cum spiritu tuo,
nixum sancti evangelii secundum Ioannem,
gloria tibi Domine.
In principio era et verbum erat ad Deum, et Deus era et verbum, hoc erat in principio ad Deum. Omni principum factus sunt in sinibus, ipso factum est nihil, quo factum est. In ipso vita erat lux hominum, et lux in tenebres, luce de tenebre, erum non comprehendebunt. Fuit homo missus ad Deum, quod nomen erat Ioannes, sic venit in testimonium, ut testimonium peperit lumen, et omnes credunt vinum. Non erit in lux, sed testimonium peperit lumen, erat lux verbum, ad lumen ad omnem hominem evidentem in mundum. In mundum erat, mundus principum factus est, mundus non coniovit. Propria veritis omnes ceperunt, quod quatra tempus ceperunt, erga est potestatem filios Dei fieri, his vigente in nomine eius, qui non est sanguinibus, nec gluttati panis, nec gluttati vinis, et donati sunt. Et verbum carnum factum est, et habitavit in nobis et vidimus gloria meus, gloria quasi unigenite a patria, per un grazia et veritatis.
Deo gratias.
God save Elizabeth our Queen.
Graciously hear us when we call upon thee.
Let us pray. Almighty God, we pray for thy servant Elizabeth our Queen, upon whom thy mercy has laid the government of this kingdom. May she be given so great a measure of every virtue, thus worthily adorned, may she turn aside from her wickedness, may she overcome her enemies, and with her consort and the royal family, may she come at last in grace to thee, the way, the truth, and the life. Amen.